the light, but we have a flashlight to help us with finding out that He is the light. This morning I have some rocks with me. These rocks might not be what many would say are the prettiest of rocks, but sometimes what's on the outside doesn't always reveal what's on the inside. Have you ever been told by mom or dad it's what's on the inside of a person that matters? How many of you have been told that before? Yeah. What's on the outside of these rocks might not be real pretty, but look on the inside of the rock as this has been cut. Isn't that cool that way? So I hold that and look at that and kind of pass that around. You can do that. I'm going to show you this one as well. AJ, you know what kind of rocks these are? What kind of rocks are these? Geodes. Yeah. Yeah, kind of the gemstones of rocks, huh? Kind of cool, huh? Okay. Just want to hold that and then kind of pass that one around. And we'll show one more. The light helps. It is heavy, yeah. Sometimes we're rough around the edges, or sometimes in our life, some bad things might happen to us on the outside in the world that we live in. There's tough times, things happen to us. Our roads are rocky roads, if you might. And we have to know that what's on the inside counts. It's Jesus who is where? Jesus is in us. He's come to each of you through the waters of holy baptism to live inside of you, to be in you, and because of that, you are very special. Each one of you is a very special child of God, and you have life in you because you have Jesus in you. So sometimes the outside doesn't tell us everything. There's an old saying, you can't read a book by its cover. But on the inside, you find the truth, the way, the truth, and the life, Jesus, who is inside of you. Let's pray now and thank Him, please. Dear Lord Jesus, thank You for being the way, the truth, and the life. Thank You for being inside of us, for making us beautiful on the inside, for giving us life. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, thank you, boys and girls. I see this one too, you can. You want to return to your seats, and we continue with something of mercy. Hold your peace.
We have received by faith.
Jesus is the perfect example of life. He is called the only authentic human being to ever live the way God had intended for us to live. He was conceived and born and lived and died all without sin. Oh, he had the opportunity. He was tempted in every way as we are. But he said no every time to those temptations. He said no to those sins. Jesus lived the life that all human beings were created to live. He is the life. Never sinned. He always obeyed God. Without reservation, without hesitation, as it says in Philippians 2, verse 8, he was obedient even unto death. Man, I can't get my kids to be obedient, and I threaten them with death, and they know I'm not going to know. We can't get ourselves to be obedient even when we know that this is the best for us. We know that God's way is the right way. And yet we still, knowing that, even experiencing pains and sufferings because of screwing it up in the past, we still choose the wrong way. Anybody else guilty of that? Because I don't want to tell about my family all day today. That's us, isn't it? That's you. It's me too. Jesus is the source of life for you. He's destroyed death. He's taken that minus and made it a plus. He's got that victory over sin and death and the power of the devil, and he's done that for us. He's that source of life, as we know that Jesus is the vine and we are the branches. He says in John 15, verse 5, he says, I am the vine, you are the branches. If a man remains in me and I in him, he will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. We need that nourishment, that feeding by being connected to the vine. When we disconnect a branch from the vine, what is it? It's a dead stick, right? Whenever we have that branch disconnected from the vine, when you are disconnected as a branch, when you are disconnected from the vine, you die. Life, your life that's in you comes because, just as we spoke with the kids, that life in us, because Jesus is in us. He is that vine, we are the branches. Jesus is the key to life. John 10:10, he says, I have come that you may have life and have it to the full. Jesus has removed the barrier between you and God. What is that barrier that was between you and God? Sin. Yeah. All the way back from the first sin in the Garden of Eden to the time that you were conceived, you've had this barrier between you and God, and he has removed that. So that barrier between God and people being removed so that we can have life with God. When? Now. Right now on earth, you have life with God. You don't have to wait till you get to heaven to have that life with God. You have that life with him now as Jesus is in you. And when you die the physical death of the body, your spiritual life continues because Jesus has broken that barrier down. We have that life with God now and forever. day he's going to give that new glorified body. In the meantime, though, some of you realize that you're stuck in the old body. Yeah. It becomes more apparent as you have to get out of bed in the morning sometimes, right? You know, I am convinced that we need to change the whole wedding policy here at St. Mark. Weddings will now be on Monday through Friday. There's no more Saturday weddings. We had a wedding yesterday. It was great. We had about 250 people for the wedding service. Wow. Yeah, that's what I say. Wow, in a great way. Love it. You know? But I'm not as young as I used to be, apparently, because, you know, weddings, wedding receptions, you know, I took my beautiful wife to the reception, got to dance with her and things that way. I think it's important that we as a godly couple and, you know, go out there, even with the clerical, we show people that the pastor can't dance, but that's okay. But it's important to show the people that it's a godly relationship between man and woman, and there's godly ways to act in public. I think that's important for people to see. Christians and non-Christians alike that way. And so I try to stick around for a while. And getting home and in bed at 11 o'clock for a pastor that's usually in bed at 10 o'clock on Saturday nights, that throws you off, all right? Dave, will you help me with that thermostat? It's defaulted and went back to heat at this point. It's not heating right now. It's not calling for heat because it's not down to 62, but it's also not calling for air. But your pastor's calling for air. Amen?
Yeah.
It's hot in here.
It is hot.
It's only a couple of degrees difference when that air goes off, but believe me, I can tell. Yeah. Get me going now. Getting out of bed, you know, because you stayed up late last night or went dancing or what have you. Sometimes it's worse than that, isn't it? How many of you have had some rocky times in your life? A lot worse than what I'm at. This morning we pray again for a little Tanner Yawn, Fred Wenzel's great-grandson. He's about 10 months old. We got the diagnosis this morning as well. Well, I got the diagnosis this morning. The family received a diagnosis for the blood work and things. Little Tanner has muscular dystrophy. It's rocky roads. Speed bumps in life. You guys don't know anything about that, though, do you? Yeah. Right. And you'll hear the prayers that during the song of praise, I was writing prayers that I received this morning. I received an additional probably 8, 9, 10 prayers this morning. Prayer list is long and deep again, with a lot of hurting, rocky situations out there. But you know what? Even in the midst of these rocky times, what's on the inside of the rock? The beauty of the inside of these geodes. Is that what you said, AJ? Yeah. All right. Thanks for keeping me in line. I need help, believe me. What's on the inside of us? Jesus, the light. Inside of that little Tanner and his family. Annie and your family. And you and your family in the rocky times, we still have that life because Jesus is the life in you. for you, defeating sin, death, and the power of the devil, so that we can live this life and have this life to the full. And that's not just here on earth, but for eternity. We know and we enjoy this life. What do we do with that, though? Do we just keep it to ourselves? About a year ago, we put this net on the wall. Has it been that long already? It has, hasn't it? About a year ago that we put that net up, and we've been doing some fishing for a year, but did we need that net up there to be doing the fishing? Where we were able to fish before the net was there, right? And when that net comes down this week, we can still continue to be fishers of men, yes? Yes. You see, the point is that as we have this life in us, as we know Jesus to be the way, the truth, and the life, and He is in us and leading us and guiding us, He is our very life, He's the one that makes us beautiful on the inside, we want to share that with others. We don't want to just hold on to it for ourselves, but we want to tell others. We want to do that fishing. We want to have our neighbors and our family and our friends and our co-workers to know this Jesus too. And so we're teaching the faithful, we're reaching the lost, we're caring for all. Some might even say that we have compassion, that we show love, that we share faith. I encourage you to do that as you have Jesus, the life in you. As you go through these doors, that you have that life in you on the other side of the doors too. And you share that life of the world with the world. People that you're going to meet and greet for the very first time this week. To that person that you've known all your life, for the last 5 years, for the last 2 weeks. Share what's on the inside. Share that Jesus. He is the way, the truth, and the life. In Jesus' holy name, amen. And now may the peace of God, which transcends all human understanding, guard your hearts and minds through faith in Christ Jesus until life everlasting. Amen.